Now, IUWF is not new. It's about closing the urban water cycle loop. In the purely physical sense, it is ensuring integration between the management of the water source, the water supply to the town, water usage at the household, commercial and industrial levels, wastewater collection and treatment, water reuse, the safe return of the treated wastewater back into the source, and finally the reuse of the nutrients. All of this is fairly well understood and obvious. But IUWF in this context is much more than that. It's about institutional integration, so that the different institutions that manage each of these urban water functions talk to each other and not at cross purposes. It's about comprehensive and fair financial models, like effective cross subsidies, so that critical needs like basic lifeline water or the environment are not ignored in the rush to go after full cost recovery. It's also about social integration, so that the issues of the poor are understood and addressed through a just pro-poor policy, and so that platforms exist for citizens to engage on programs that are being planned for them. We believe firmly that there is a lot of room for innovation here, for coming up with exciting new models of being urban and sustainable. And as we're all seeing, this is a search that's happening all over the world. So to put this theory into practice, we decided to take up a pilot program in Mumbai. And that has been the satellite imagery for Mumbai. How does one approach IUWF for Mumbai? Conceptually, it's clear that the program has to be owned and embedded within the municipality if it is to survive, if it is to sustain. But it also needs to bring in experts from various disciplines to build this model. Arjun is facilitating this effort, working with government, partners from development agencies, research institutions and NGOs. This is a long project. We expect it to be 3 to 5 years at least, and we're only 1 year into it. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about the process that we followed for developing and implementing an IUWF plan for the city. The first step is to build participation. In India, there is always a lag between the technical and the social aspects of any intervention. The technical or the engineering portion speeds ahead. Systems are set up, pipes are made. But the poor still don't get water, pumps still break down and don't get fixed, and they still end up with sewage. Lots of experiences on the ground have shown that strong ownership and participation are needed for systems to work smoothly and fairly. And this can happen only by empowering community organizations such as those and by building capacities. All of those involved in the project, whether it's the government stakeholders, the community, or the IUWF partners, need to play their roles in a well-orchestrated manner so that the activities are coordinated. And for this to happen, new institutional structures are needed. For instance, at the town level, there will be a town-level working group comprising the community representatives, CPOs, NGOs, etc. This group is very important. It's the group that's going to hold it all together. The next step is the provisioning of basic services to the urban poor. Again, experiences from the ground reveal that the needs of the poor have to be addressed upfront and with their total participation. In this project, a grassroots NGO will work with community and facilitate interventions for water supply and sanitation for the slums. A starting point for actually putting together the plan will be the baseline studies. 3 sets of studies are being planned. The first is the Municipal Water Resources Survey, which is going to include an asset inventory, and that's going to lead to a water resource GIS map for the town. The second is a hydrogeological mapping of the town. Remember, this town is 100% dependent on groundwater. This mapping will be done by monitoring bore wells, and that will be used to create a groundwater model for designing and tracking groundwater interventions. This is probably the first time in India that such an approach is being tried. The third is the very important community mapping exercise. That is one such example. And this will lead us to understanding people's issues, interests and priorities. The next step would be to actually develop the IUWF plan. The data from these studies will be analyzed and will form the basis for the plan for the town, which will be developed through a participatory visioning exercise. This will be driven by the town-level working group to ensure deep participation. The same town level working group will likewise engage with the implementation and the monitoring of all the projects in the town. Another key innovation that I want to talk about is the e-governance platform that's going to tie this all together. We wanted to take a systemic approach to IOWN through the use of IT and computer technologies. A critical point to note here is that e-governance products need to start with the existing systems that the municipalities are already using and build upon them, as opposed to starting with something new and unfamiliar, because then it just will not get used. For instance, ULPs in Karnataka use the works management module to manage various civic works, be it asphalting roads or laying drains. They use an asset management module to operate and maintain the assets that result from these works. They use an accrual-based financial accounting system to track their finances. And finally, they use a public grievance redressal system to address the problems of citizens. All of these map to core functions of the municipality today. Our technology partner has already implemented these e-governance modules for cities of Karnataka. Now we are working with them to extend these modules and add on water-related features for each of them to enable IOWN. The twofold objective of e-governance is to improve efficiencies of administration through computerization and to bring in transparency and accountability by using web-based systems which will make data available for all citizens. With some customization and training, these products can be taken to other urban areas in a fairly structured manner. By using such a systemic approach, we will be able to leverage the large investments going into urban India and help small towns leapfrog onto the digital track. So, this is a brief look at our experiment in Mulbagal. Some of these elements are new, some are proven models, and there are a lot of challenges ahead. But we believe that the uniqueness of this approach lies in the 360-degree outlook and the practical approach that we've taken to small town water management. Thank you.